Good evening, everyone. My name is Beth Fazina, and I work here at the college in the offices of Transfer and Veteran Services. It is my pleasure to welcome you all tonight to the 19th annual Phi Theta Kappa induction ceremony. I would also like to congratulate all of the inductees on their accomplishments. While you may have benefited from BCC, BCC has also benefited from your contributions to our community. Now I am honored to introduce our guests on the stage. President Spraga. Vice President of Academic Affairs, Greg Satharis. Vice President of Students and Preparedness, Steve Ozuk. Associate Vice President of Academic Affairs, Anthony Ucci. Associate Vice President of Academic Affairs, Anna Gayette. Coordinator of Transfer Services, Eileen Shea. Phi Theta Kappa Advisor and Associate Professor of History, Donald Kilgus. Phi Theta Kappa Student Representative and Student Trustee, Samuel Lima. At this time, I'd like to invite President Spraga to the podium.
Well, thank you. I'd like to welcome you to Bristol Community College. This is a wonderful evening, and we celebrate excellence, and that's what Bristol Community College is all about. It's a little bittersweet occasion for me because, like you, this is my last PTK ceremony, as I'll be leaving later this year in the spring. So I wish you all the best. I will go out together from BCC and do wonderful things, I'm sure. I want to tell you what I tell all students is that you can go anywhere from BCC, and I know that you will continue to excel, you'll continue to shine, you'll continue to represent BCC in the best possible tradition. And for all of you family and loved ones and friends, I want to thank you for the support that you have provided to our students as they march through the curriculum, excelling all the way through. This is not an easy award to win tonight, be inducted in the PTK Society. So I thank you for your support, and I know that the award winners also thank you. I think we're moving ahead. What a wonderful evening tonight, and I'm gonna get out of the way so we can enjoy and celebrate the people who are involved. Thank you for your excellence, and thank you for your BCC tradition.
Vice President Satharis.
Thank you very much. I'm very honored tonight to give just a few brief comments on behalf of the college, the academic deans and administrators, but most importantly on behalf of our faculty and professional staff, those that have guided you so far in your journey and will continue on until your commencement. So to students, families, friends, loved ones, everyone here tonight, welcome to Bristol Community College and congratulations on this great achievement. I always find that the success of remarks at an event such as this are inversely related to the length of the comments, so I will do my best to keep them very brief. As students being inducted into the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society this evening, you have not achieved this level of success by yourself. You obviously have your loved ones, your family, your friends who are with you here tonight, and many who are not with you here tonight, so congratulations to everyone on the induction. On your induction here tonight, but not only the students, but also family, friends, and loved one. Our students could not do what they do, could not achieve what they achieve without your support along the way. And as my comments in about a minute will get to, they're gonna need that continued support and love from you, not only through this year, but through the upcoming years. You will oftentimes hear that a college education is not an end where you leave college, go off, get a job, but it is indeed the beginning, and that is definitely true here tonight. So my one critical comment to you is for you, not only in your time here at BCC, but beyond, not to stop. It's not an associate's degree, your associate's degree, your time here with us is not the end. It is the beginning to a life of scholarship, but also a life of professionalism. Professionalism is what connects your education to your career and your life serving yourself, your friends, your family, and your community. Your life of scholarship and your education will certainly help you gain employment, and that is indeed why many people go off for higher education. It will help transform your employment status even more so. More than being an employee with a good job, your education is what will help you transform your life into that of a professional, one who's able to transform your skill set throughout your life as you adjust to a changing world. This will be with you forever as you engage not only in a life of employment, but that of civic engagement, supporting yourself and your communities and families and loved ones. So my message to you, as you achieve this goal tonight of being inducted into Phi Theta Kappa, is continue on with your education, understanding that in today's world, your development is never, ever complete. So after BCC, after your associate's degree, think bachelor's degree, think master's degree, think advanced certificate and credential, think PhD, think beyond. There's no limit to what you can do. So as you thank those who are here tonight, who love you, those who are not able to be here tonight with you, for their support and love as you've achieved this goal, make sure you sort of also whisper in their ear that you're going to need that love and support as you continue on, and they're going to need it from you as well. So congratulations to all of you, and welcome.
Vice President Ozug will now present the Phi Theta Kappa Distinguished Service Award.
Good evening, everyone. It is quite an honor for me to be able to present this award tonight to this amazing individual, this incredible resource to Bristol Community College, and to this just all-around fantastic human being. The validity of Eileen's receipt of the Phi Theta Kappa Distinguished Service Award is indisputable. Over the past 40 years, Eileen's work has engendered the development of a complex and interwoven network of transfer and articulation, designed to expand access and opportunity for students and to make Bristol Community College a model institution for transfer programming. Eileen's ambition, her aim, has always been to make the process of transition from the associate to the baccalaureate level of education easy, smooth, and straightforward. Coupled with her goal to expand opportunity and affordability for students, the success of these initiatives takes extensive collaboration, careful orchestration, and persistent invigoration. Eileen applies her circumspection into every detail of this vast architecture, from guiding statewide groups on the development of policies to convening faculty for complex negotiations and to shaping the processes that make these well-crafted programs work effectively. She has been the visionary, the pioneer, the amalgamist, and the contemplator to designing these mechanisms. But ultimately, in the end, for her, it's all about the students, which is why, among her many student proteges, she has regularly advised the Presidential Scholars students in support of exceptional learning and achievement. She is the recipient of numerous local and national awards, including the New England Transfer Association Distinguished Service Award and the National Institute for Staff and Organizational Development Excellence Award. Eileen's impact is both foundational and perpetual. There's not likely one element of transfer at BCC or within the Commonwealth that remains untouched by her. Eileen founded BCC's Beta Eta Phi chapter of the Phi Theta Kappa International Honor Society. And over 19 years ago, she developed the very ceremony you are attending tonight. For these many years, her influence has made it possible for students of exemplary scholarship, all of you, to be honored among their families, mentors, and peers. Tonight, we also honor her by bestowing upon her the Phi Theta Kappa Distinguished Service Award. Please join me in congratulating and welcoming up here Eileen Shea.
Thank you, Steve, and thank you to my colleagues who have kindly nominated me for this award. First, let me congratulate all of you for your outstanding academic achievements. You and your family should take great pride in your accomplishments. Because you have demonstrated such great potential, let BCC be the start of your educational career and not the end. Four-year colleges and universities are knocking at our door looking for students just like you. You would be amazed at the many transfer opportunities that are available to you. I invite you to come and visit us in the transfer office, get to know us, use the transfer services available to you to find the four-year transfer path that's right for you. In my career, I have been so lucky to have had the chance to work with such outstanding students. I am so proud to be standing here with you tonight, and I want to thank you for letting me share a little of the spotlight. But make no mistake, tonight, the light is shining on you. Thank you.
Associate Vice President Ucci.
Good evening. I'm pleased to present these candidates for membership to our society. These students have fulfilled all requirements for membership. I recommend them for acceptance into the Beta Eta Phi chapter of the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society.
Student Representative Samuel Lima.
Good evening. This is the emblem of Phi Theta Kappa. The gold field refers to the golden opportunities available to us all. Since gold is the most noble of metals, it has further significance to our society. For it represents the nobility attained by those who achieve intellectual leadership. Across the gold field is a black band. It represents the three ideals which band us together. Shining through the black enamel background are the three Greek letters which are the initials of three Greek words meaning wisdom, aspiration, and purity. Behind the band is a wreath. On the one side, composed of the oak leaves, and on the other, laurel. The oak leaves stand for stability and strength of the character. The graceful curling leaves of the laurel signify achievement and success and all attributes for membership in our society. Above the band is the representation of the head of Athena, the goddess of learning, and the base appear the Greek letters meaning light, the light of knowledge and learning. The common ideal for members of Phi Theta Kappa, this badge stands as a symbol of the high idealism of our organization and membership in our select group. The purpose of our organization is to foster among its members a spirit of devotion to the hallmarks of Phi Theta Kappa, leadership, service, and fellowship, and to create a welcoming intellectual climate for the interchange of ideas and ideals. Among us, membership is a privilege earned by academic merit, honor, and service. In the conduct of our activities, truth shall be our quest, diligence our staff, and achievement of excellence our purpose. Thank you.
We will now begin the official induction. Vice President Ozug will call out each candidate's name. When your name is announced, please come to the induction table, pick up your candle, and please remain standing when you return to your seat.
Declan Tabor. Jessica Costa. Deanna Cross. Scott Linden. Colleen Michener. Danielle Cabral. Anna Amaral. Sandra Caceres. Brenda Ritchie. Kevin Murphy. Keith Dion. Rachel Aubin. Chelsea Barnes. Karina DeMora. Eric Botello. Adam Francoeur. Aiden Gula. Kylie Pasternak. Stephen Hall. Nicole Latimer. Alexis Mercado. Jade Shadburn. Amy Dodenhoff. Christopher Azevedo. Amy Gregoire. Krista Barrows. Valeria Pareja. Nadia Habush. Kerry Branquino. Kimberly Dos Santos. Shiv Thakur. June Fishback. Colby Ferreira. Johanna Boynton. Wayne Sylvia. Raylene Baggy. Tess Melanson. Samantha Rupkus Mello. Kylie Tavares. Jacob Carrero. Solomon Carrero. Raksa Soon. Brianna Carrera. Shamaya Nathaniel. Elmer Paz. Erica Mendes. Edwin Cartagena.
That was an easy one.
Matthew Oliver. Debbie Barraby. Mary Hanning. Irini Mavridis. Erica Romehild. Courtney Cunha. Nicole Tardanico. Ashley Youngblood. Yuko Hook. Samantha Maurice. Dylan Potoff. Kevin Medeiros. Samuel Lima.
Associate Vice President Guyette.
Now that the standard and ideals of this organization have been revealed to you, we ask you to recite the pledge which admits you into complete fellowship. So please repeat after me. I do solemnly promise on this 31st day of March of 2017 to uphold the standards of Phi Theta Kappa, and to make this object the aim foremost in my mind. And I do solemnly pledge allegiance to my fellow members. And promise to aid them in all worthy endeavors. It is my pleasure to welcome you into the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society and the lively fellowship of scholars that it affords. I salute you for your accomplishment. I charge you to explore always the truth and to dedicate yourselves to the cultivation of the well-reasoned life, a prelude to service and honor. Please be seated.
Congratulations. You can blow out your candles now. Professor Don Kilgus.
Thank you and congratulations. It is so nice to have an evening like this when we can all come together as the BCC family and celebrate student achievement. I do realize that I am the last person standing between you and the goodies outside, you know, so I'm going to keep it brief, as Vice President Sidaris said earlier. I would like to congratulate all the inductees for everything that you've accomplished here at Bristol Community College. Your accomplishments have been the result of an enormous amount of hard work, dedication, and sacrifice. And I know many of you would not be here tonight if it was not for the support of your families. We all owe our parents, spouses, and children so many thanks for encouraging us to achieve our goals when times were difficult or when we doubted ourselves. So I would like to take just a quick moment to please thank all your family and friends that are here that helped you along the way. When I think about Phi Theta Kappa students, one of the first things that comes to mind is dedication. You come to class each day while juggling the great responsibilities of classes, work, family, and college activities. You are the masters of time management as you adroitly balance all of the demands on your time and energy. And despite all the pressures, you willingly share of yourselves, both inside and outside of the classroom. We are all inspired by your example as self-motivated lifetime learners who embrace learning with a passion and enthusiasm that is remarkable to witness. As you have proceeded along your educational journey, I'm sure that many of your decisions have been influenced by your family or by your faith or by something that many of you might consider to be serendipity or destiny. During the midst of the Great Depression, President Roosevelt stated, quote, "There is a mysterious cycle in human events. To some generations, much is given. Of other generations, much is expected. This generation of Americans has a rendezvous with destiny." You also have an opportunity through organizations like Phi Theta Kappa to not only make your own destiny, but at the same time to help shape the destiny of others. When you received your invitation to join Phi Theta Kappa, you also received an invitation to get involved to better the college community. I realize that we all have many responsibilities both inside and outside of the classroom, as I spoke of earlier. But the college community, your college community, is only as vibrant as the members make it. Therefore, as the faculty advisor here at BCC, I ask all of you to consider becoming as involved as your time, interests, and other commitments will allow. Your involvement can consist of anything from running for a student government position to participating in a civic engagement project to serving as a mentor to new students. Remember that whatever you do helps to fulfill the hallmarks of Phi Theta Kappa: scholarship, leadership, service, and fellowship, now and in the future. I encourage you to be involved, be a role model, be a mentor. In other words, pay it forward. Thank you, congratulations again, and enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you.